And now, on with the show.
Well, here we are again.
Joком 쑥스럽기도 하고 제가 이렇게 한국말로 얘기하는 거 누구도 못 알아듣지만 like the word 맞춰서
I don't know anything about you anyway. You're from Italy, aren't you?
Si.
You know what I mean?
Yes, I know exactly what you mean.
Ciao, come stai?
If you still want me, yes. I could do some of the things I've always wanted.
Like what?
I'd like to do just whatever I like the whole day long.
Why don't we do all those things together?
Enjoy life, time, study.
Before I found a place to live in Positano, I spent a short time living in the nearby village of Atrani. Let me tell you a story about the day I met Maurizio, a hiking guide who offered to take me on a little trek called Il Sentiero degli Dei, the Path of the Gods.
Okay, so we've only just started the trip. Now you see me, I'm still, I'm not too sweaty. I've still got energy to talk. We'll see how I go later on. But I can tell you, mamma mia, it is so beautiful. The hills are covered in wildflowers. I would say May is the best time to do this because everything is in bloom. It's not too hot. And, just being up here, it doesn't take long to sort of get into this really sort of secluded area here in the hills. We just walked up some steps past some little tiny houses with their little gardens growing vegetables and herbs. Oh, I just love it here. People think of the Amalfi Coast as being all about the beaches. You're swimming, going on boats, but there's this whole other side which you must experience. The tranquility, the peace that is up here, the natural beauty. Oh, it's just astounding, and it makes you feel so alive.
Is there anything on these hills that you can eat? You know, is there anything?
Most of the plants growing around.
Oh, really?
Are eligible, yes.
Yeah.
We can see nasturtium.
Yes. Nasturtiums. Yeah.
Borage.
Borage.
We
okay.
eat the flowers
yes.
of both.
Yes.
And well, we have garlic growing wild.
Oh, I love wild garlic. Yeah.
We have a lot of herbs like rosemary, oregano, mm-hmm.
yes.
Thyme, lemon and thyme, proper thyme.
And in fact, I think it's interesting when you see wild garlic for the first time. I saw it. I was like, it's so beautiful, the flowers. And then yeah. you realize, there's also garlic inside.
We use it for cooking.
Yeah.
The wild version doesn't develop the big bulb under the soil, but
yes.
we use the stem. So
yeah, yeah,
you
yeah.
simply cut the stem and use it for cooking.
Fantastic.
Ready. And... if you wish to try, you can chew the stem, like this.
It's quite sweet. It's garlicky, but it's quite sweet.
Mm. Plantago officinalis. Significa che sono piante mediche.
Ok.
Quindi questa basta lasciarla in tasca in modo che si ammorbidisce un po' dopo qualche ora e poi puoi passarla sopra, insomma, al morso di zanzara che
sì.
uso. That's fennel. Decorating, and also they have a very nice smell. If you take it away, when we were kids, we used to use this to whistle the birds. You know, birds have a kind of a Morse code when singing. If you listen to them and try to reproduce their singing, they sing something and then they waiting for the answer. So if you enter the conversation in the right timing, you might receive an answer from them. Let's wait for someone. Yeah, this one here. Do you listen to the answer? A very nice and funny games as a child, because to do this you need to listen.
Yeah, yeah. You become more aware, no?
Yeah.
Even
yeah.
più consapevole.
Because otherwise you walk into the vegetation without noticing anything. We didn't have computer games or PlayStation, so we used to make and build our own games. That was our playground in, when we were kids.
Che bello.
Okay. Okay, andiamo.
One of the games they played as children was guessing from the flower buds what color petals they would have inside.
How many years old is it?
That's about 400 years old.
400 years old. Explain to you the serenity that you feel here. It's just magical. We've arrived at one of the churches and we're going to take a look inside. It just all feels untouched. You have no idea what era you're in, because you know we could be walking through these hills 100 years ago and it's all still the same.
The fresco behind me, Maurizio says, is over 600 years old, and it's so beautiful. I'm really moved by it. You can see that there's the Madonna, and she's cradling the baby in the middle, and her eyes follow you wherever you go. And it's meant to be quite comforting. You know, Maurizio says she will be there for you. She's looking over you like the mother, the mama. Up above, you can also see Jesus, and his eyes also follow you, and he's got the rule book. So he says that there are two parts to the message, where he's looking over you and saying, stay attento, follow the rules, be disciplined, because he is always watching you as well as the Madonna. This was the most powerful way to communicate a message, obviously, because in those times, 600 years ago, not many people knew how to read or write. But you look at this image, this whole scene, and it's very powerful and it's very effective, he said. To the right of the Madonna, you can see five people. You won't recognize them. They're not angels, they're not biblical figures. They are essentially the sponsors of the fresco, because they commissioned it, they paid for it, and somehow they worked out a way to get their faces, the faces of the five family members, into this fresco. And now they have a legacy that hopefully will last forever.
Oh, I'm just having the best day. After the church, Maurizio just comes up to me and says, now I'm just going to show you where my mother and father are working here in this garden. All of this produce here is organic, is absolutely delicious. He's just given me these to try. And I can't tell you. It's like so sweet, these peas. I'm sitting here eating fresh vegetables just picked by a local farmer, looking out at this view over the Costiera Amalfitana. I feel really, really happy. It just all makes sense, doesn't it? It's like this is how life should be. It's so simple, and this family is so happy. You know, he comes in and he's like, Mama, ciao. She comes up from picking these and gives him a big kiss. Was it dreams ago? My heart felt this glow. Non dimenticare. Means don't forget you are my darling. Don't forget to be all you mean to me. No, è un video.
È
E lei come si chiama?
Michele.
Michele.
Grazie.
Lei invece...
Giuseppina.
Giuseppina.
Adesso carciofini che abbiamo fatto noi.
Sì.
Vuole assaggiare?
Sì.
Poi io faccio colazione con questa la mattina.
Ah sì?
Mi porto qua su.
Lei è nato qua, no?
Sì, 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 è nato nel convento.
Ah sì?
Nel 38.
Wow. And he grew up in the convent because apparently the monks what they would do is they would rent out parts of the convent, and so he grew up in these hills. I mean, can you imagine what a life? It's just incredible.
Non è stata messa nessun medicinale. Questa è la carciofa che facciamo quelli.
Sì, sì. Ecco perché il sapore è così buono, no? I mean, Maurizio's mother and father are in their 70s and they come up here, they walk up here because it's the only way to get up here every day, and they come up at about 5 a.m. and they go down by 1 p.m. they said, and they have breakfast, which is tomatoes and mozzarella. It's the type of lifestyle you don't even believe it still exists, but it does.
La vostra vita
è semplice, ma sì.
È bellissima, cioè così bisogna vivere, no?
I miei hanno la stessa mentalità.
Ah, sì. Sono la natura.
Sì, e poi hanno molto rispetto per la natura, sì, e l'ambiente.
Sì, anche
noi. E poi noi siamo, cioè, una famiglia molto stretta, perché quando stai in mezzo alla natura...
Sì, diventa anche più buono.
Esatto, senza la televisione, il traffico, tutto il resto. Sì, no, è fantastico.
Salute.
Think of anything that I would rather have right now after doing that big long trek, and you come down these stairs and you see these lemons and these oranges and this beautiful ragazza and this is so refreshing. You just make it with lemons,
ma è fatto con limone, solo un limone e acqua, basta. Ah, niente zucchero. No, niente zucchero.
Wow. So sì, infatti. Yeah, so incredible. I mean, it's really, really natural because it's just lemons and water. That's it. No sugar, no colouring. Oh, it's so good. It's so good. I can't tell you. It's just like quenches your thirst. What is your name? Come ti chiami?
Marilu.
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 To get home, I was waiting at a bus stop and a car with a family slowed down and said, "Ciao, ma tu sei Kylie, l'australiana? You're Kylie, the Australian. Where are you going? Please, let us give you a lift. The bus is never on time." And it was such a perfect end to a day spent in the company of kind, genuine people.
What a day. I've come home and I feel like I've been on some kind of really emotional adventure, and you're probably laughing at me or shaking your head and thinking, "Oh, why is she so sentimental?" But I think it's the fact that you're up there, you're with nature, and I don't know if this has ever happened to you, but when you've met someone or a family or a group of people for the first time, and almost within 30 seconds you have this warmth and this instant rapport, and that's what happened for me today with Maurizio and his family, his parents. I couldn't I felt almost as though I was being adopted into their family. I mean, the mother is gripping my hand and saying, I've always wanted a filia, I've always wanted a daughter, and we would imagine that she would be like you. And of course, I'd be adopted by an Italian family in a heartbeat. But the thing is that Maurizio and his family, they have such a beautiful way of approaching life. It's just simplicity. It's hard work. They get up at 5 a.m. in the morning. They walk all the way up the mountain to where they have their orto, their garden, and work the fields, do what they have to do, pruning, sort of collecting the vegetables. And they have a coffee and they eat their little artichokes and their homemade bread. Oh gosh, I don't know. It just for me is, this is the reason I moved to Italy, because of families like that, because of lifestyles like that. It's very inspiring, and I'm just so grateful to have been let into their life, even if just for a day.
Thank you to my patrons, who are the reason you're all watching this episode right now. Their kind donations, whether it's $1 a month or more, make it possible for me to put out films more frequently and work on this full time. Please subscribe to my channel, give the video a little thumbs up, and I hope you'll come back next episode.